That's a hard one. You know, mostly because when you say the church, there's so many facets to the church. We find that everywhere in the world where we're studying what's going on, and really we do most of our research in the United States, but even in some of the other places that we've had some access to what's going on, we find that there are great things happening everywhere. If you think of the church as being individuals who want to be Christ-like and are doing everything they can to fulfill that, yeah, the church is always relevant. It can't not be relevant. But if we talk about the church as the institution, the structures, the organizations that have all been set up, that's where it starts to get bogged down. We begin to lose track of who we are, where we're going, how we're going to get there, what success is. I'll give you a great example. One of my mantras in life, so to speak, is you get what you measure. And one of the things that we discovered as we studied Christian churches in the United States, we interviewed a few thousand pastors and asked them all kinds of questions. One of those was, is your church successful? And an overwhelming majority of them said, well, yes. And so the follow-up question was, great, how do you measure success? And we found that across the country, there are five dominant measures that are used in churches to determine whether or not the church is successful. Attendance, do we have more people attending this week than we had last week? Budget, are we raising the amount of money we said that we needed to do all the stuff we're trying to do? Programs, do we have more programs going on now than we had last year? Staff, have we hired more staff than we had last year? And square footage, how much of the property have we built out? Do we have more and more facilities for people to utilize? Now, those are all wonderful things. But it occurred to me there's only one problem with those five measures, and that's that Jesus didn't die for any of those. He didn't die to put butts in the seats. He didn't die to, have money thrown in the plate so that we could erect more buildings. None of that has anything to do with his agenda. So, if we begin to measure things using the right metrics, I think that helps us get a better grip on whether or not the church is relevant. When we're focused on the things that were at the heart of where Jesus was at, that's when we're relevant. We can't not be relevant at that point in time. But when we start adopting the world's philosophy of what success is and what purpose is, that's when we really lose our way.